Welcome to our brand new series, Destination Do-Over. My name is Samuel.
And I'm Amanda.
And we're from Allura Studios, a production house from Atlanta, Georgia that releases travel-related content. We have 7 days to explore this beautiful city, which means we have a full agenda. So we've packed as many cultural experiences, historical landmarks, signature cuisines, and travel tips as we possibly can.
So stay tuned for our 8-part series, Destination Do-Over.
Welcome back, viewers. It's a little bit of a later start today. We decided to have breakfast at the hostel, India House Hostel, of course, you remember. It was amazing. I think we had sliders. This time on our last trip, we were heading down to the French Quarter to learn about mysticism and voodoo in New Orleans. But that's for another day this time.
Today, we're going to visit the biggest park in New Orleans, the City Park. And it's a good thing that we have these streetcar passes to help us get everywhere we need to go. This park is the biggest in New Orleans and has over 5 million visitors yearly. It is the site of concerts, events, festivals, and many lazy afternoons for the residents of this city.
It is also one of the top 100 largest parks in the U.S., 50% larger than Central Park in New York, and it was originally in Plantation, which is a pretty common history for places around here. It became public property in the 1850s, and in 1891 it was officially named City Park.
We are mostly here today to have a more relaxed exploration morning because this afternoon we will be digging into the history of music and jazz in New Orleans, but there are still a few sites and landmarks of note here, so let's go find them.
The first thing you will see when you get off the stop here is the Bayou St. John, which is beautiful and sits here just outside the park. The neighborhood over there is also called Bayou St. John. Now then, let's go inside the park.
After you've seen that, the first thing you will see entering the park will be the singing oak tree. This tree is called so for the hidden chimes hanging from the branches. They're only out seasonally, though.
Next thing that we're going to see is the dueling oaks. So as you can see, there's not two dueling oaks left, there's only one. In 1949, the second dueling oak was actually destroyed in a hurricane. But this is not called the dueling oak trees because of how the trees were shaped, but more what happened here. So this is the most famous place in New Orleans for duels. And some of the most famous duels of history were actually done right here.
The next closest landmark is the Sidney and Walda Besthoff Sculpture Garden, which is really close to the New Orleans Museum of Art. Between the two, this is a large installation of artwork. I know Sam is excited.
Yeah, there's a sculpture in there by one of my favorite feminist artists, Louise Bourgeois, and I'm super excited to finally see it in person. And then we accidentally got into Storyland, which was closed for repairs. This just goes to show that you have to be able to accept that not everything will go according to plan. For we were supposed to see a few other things in Storyland, but it was closed, so we could not.
And the last thing that we are going to explore here at City Park is the Bayou Metairie. This bayou is what gives life to this part of New Orleans. The Metairie Bayou is home to one of the largest and also the oldest live oak sanctuaries, and it is beautiful.
One of the best places to get a nice view of the bayou is actually called the peristyle. The peristyle is a neoclassical structure that is really just a place to sit and enjoy the view. It's also very popular to be used as a venue for weddings or other kinds of events like that.
On the other side of this bayou is the Oak Grove. Despite being in the bustling, busy city, it's one of the most relaxing places to be, and it's very shaded.
All right, now that we've worked up an appetite, I think it's time to go grab some lunch. What do you think?
Yes.
All right, come on, cram crew, let's go.
Okay, so now it's time for us to head back to the hostel and have a little siesta, which is very common in Italy.
Which means I'm all about that idea.
So we're gonna head back, take a nap, and definitely a shower.
Absolutely.
And don't forget to check out our other videos and make sure you give this one a like.
And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to our channel. We're about halfway through this particular series, but there will be plenty more to come from the Laura Studio, so make sure that you never miss it.